ChatGPT is an artificial intelligence program that can answer questions using a generative pre-trained transformer large language model. The program has achieved a high level of performance in many fields, and it is now available for testing by the general public. ChatGPT has been able to pass bar exams for lawyers and college entrance exams. I wanted to see how it would answer questions about the Carolina Bays. For several years, I have reported that well-preserved Carolina Bays have elliptical morphology, and that this implies that the bays originated as inclined conical cavities because ellipses are conic sections. My first question to ChatGPT was, why do the Carolina Bays have a mathematically precise elliptical geometry? Here is the response. The Carolina Bays are a series of elliptical depressions found along the Atlantic coast of the United States, primarily in North and South Carolina. These depressions have been a subject of scientific study and speculation for many years. While there is no definitive answer, several theories have been proposed to explain their elliptical geometry. One theory suggests that the Carolina Bays were formed by a cosmic event, such as an impact from a comet or asteroid. According to this theory, the elliptical shape is a result of the angle at which the object struck the Earth's surface and the subsequent formation of a crater. The impact hypothesis suggests that multiple objects struck the Earth in a fragmented manner, causing the elliptical shapes we observe today. Another hypothesis proposes that the Carolina Bays were formed by processes such as wind and water erosion over an extended period. This theory suggests that prevailing winds and water currents shape the depressions into their elliptical forms. It is important to note that the precise elliptical geometry of the Carolina Bays is still a subject of scientific debate, and researchers continue to investigate and refine these theories. Additionally, other factors, such as the geological history and local environmental conditions, may also play a role in shaping the elliptical features. Further research and analysis are necessary to gain a more complete understanding of their formation. ChatGPT makes statements as if they are facts. According to ChatGPT, the precise elliptical geometry of the Carolina Bays is still a subject of scientific debate. One of the reasons why I developed a program for fitting ellipses to Carolina Bays using the least squares method was to have an objective procedure of evaluating the geometry of the bays. The least squares method applies equally well to the Nebraska rainwater basins, and it shows that these basins also have a precise elliptical geometry. I challenged ChatGPT by saying, the elliptical geometry of the Carolina Bays can be demonstrated using the least squares method. Why is that subject to debate? ChatGPT replied, I apologize for any confusion caused. The statement that the elliptical geometry of the Carolina Bays can be demonstrated using the least square method is not accurate. As an AI language model, I do not have access to real-time data or recent scientific studies beyond my September 2021 knowledge cutoff. Therefore, I am not aware of any new research or developments related to the Carolina Bays since then. ChatGPT first apologizes for the confusion and then says that my statement that the elliptical geometry of the Carolina Bays can be demonstrated using the least squares method is not accurate. Really? That is the kind of response that I would expect from Cremonini, who refused to look through Galileo's telescope to verify that Jupiter had moons. Bad kitty cat. Here, kitty kitty, let me kick you. However, as of my last update, the exact formation mechanism of the Carolina Bays remains a subject of scientific debate, and there is no widely accepted consensus on their origin. Various hypotheses have been proposed, including the impact hypothesis and the wind and water erosion hypothesis, as mentioned earlier. It's important to note that the least squares method is a mathematical technique commonly used to find the best fit ellipse for a set of data points. If researchers have applied this method to the Carolina Bays and obtained an elliptical fit, it would be an interesting observation. However, it does not necessarily provide a definitive explanation for the origin of the Carolina Bays, as there would be other factors at play. Scientific debates typically arise due to the need for further evidence, testing, and replication of results to support or refute any proposed theories. To obtain the most up-to-date and accurate information regarding the debate surrounding the Carolina Bays and their elliptical geometry, I recommend consulting recent scientific literature or contacting experts in the field who have conducted specific studies on this topic. I wanted to ask ChatGPT one last question that involved the radial alignment of the Carolina Basin and the Nebraska rainwater basins toward the Great Lakes. I asked, can you explain why the orientations of the Carolina Basin and the Nebraska rainwater basins converge by the Great Lakes? ChatGPT replied, the convergence of the orientations of the Carolina Basin and the Nebraska rainwater basins near the Great Lakes is an interesting observation that has been noted by some researchers. However, it is important to note that the exact cause of this convergence is still a subject of scientific investigation, and there is no universally accepted explanation at this time. One hypothesis suggests that the convergence of orientations could be a result of glacial processes during the last ice age. During the Pleistocene epoch, large ice sheets covered parts of North America, including the region around the Great Lakes. As the ice sheets advanced and retreated, they could have influenced the flow of water and sediment, leading to the formation of the Carolina Basin and the Nebraska rainwater basins. The orientation convergence near the Great Lakes could be a reflection of the glacial dynamics and the influence of ice-related processes on the landscape. ChatGPT goes back to the wind and water hypothesis to try to explain the convergence of the orientations. There is no mention of ejecta from an impact on the ice sheets. Another hypothesis suggests that the orientation convergence could be related to the influence of regional tectonic forces. Crustal stress and geological structures could have played a role in shaping the orientations of these features, although the specific mechanisms and relationships are still being studied. Regional tectonic forces. I have never read any papers suggesting that tectonic forces influence the orientation of the Carolina Basin. According to ChatGPT, the specific mechanisms are still being studied. By whom? It would be nice to have some bibliographic references. This is an instance of ChatGPT just making up stuff in one of those hallucinations that have been reported. A hallucination in artificial intelligence refers to the generation of output that may sound plausible but is either factually incorrect or unrelated to the given context. Out of curiosity, I did a search on Google for the query, tectonic forces influence the orientation of the Carolina Basin, and I looked at the first three results. The first one was irrelevant because it just had Carolina Basin, but the word tectonic was missing. The second result from Google had Carolina Basin and the word tectonic. I retrieved the reference and it said, quote, there are many natural processes that can lead to lake formation, such as volcanoes, the movement of tectonic plates, and glaciers moving across the Earth. These processes, however, don't explain the strange shape and orientation of Carolina Basin. If the basin weren't created by tectonic forces or glaciers, how did they get here? That question has been the focus of spirited scientific debate for over a century. End quote. It is very clear that this paper does not say that tectonic forces influence the Carolina Basin. The third result from Google mentioned Carolina Basin and the word tectonic. This was a 65-page PDF rather than a web page. The paper is about the tectonic history of Cape Fear River Valley. One paragraph discusses sand transport and mentions that, quote, the orientation of dunes in Carolina Basin records a southwesterly wind direction, end quote. The article suggests that the orientation of the basin was caused by the wind, but does not mention the involvement of tectonic forces. It seems that ChatGPT gained its knowledge by skimming search results and building associations that only exist in the search results rather than within the source documents. Bad kitty cat.
Oui, mauvais chat.
Let me kick you. ChatGPT continues on the question of the convergence of the basin. It's important to note that these are hypotheses, and further research is needed to gather more evidence and determine the precise mechanisms behind the convergence of orientations. Scientific investigations often involve analyzing geological, geomorphological, and geophysical data, as well as conducting field studies and numerical modeling to test different hypotheses and gain a better understanding of the processes involved. ChatGPT concludes, if you are interested in exploring this topic further, I recommend consulting recent scientific literature or reaching out to experts in the field who have studied the Carolina Basin and the Nebraska rainwater basin specifically. They would be the best source of up-to-date and detailed information on this subject. To use ChatGPT, you need to open an account with OpenAI.com. ChatGPT can remember what you said earlier in the conversation session, and it allows you to provide follow-up corrections. The program has also been trained to decline inappropriate requests. I suppose that if you tell it to go to hell, it will not do so unless you give it the GPS coordinates. The program has the following warning. ChatGPT may produce inaccurate information about people, places, or facts. Artificial intelligence is the holy grail of computer science. In 1966, ELIZA was a chatbot that used simple pattern matching on input text and responded with questions that gave the impression that the computer understood the topic. In 1997, Deep Blue was a chess-playing computer that won against Garry Kasparov, a reigning world champion, under regular time controls. Today, chess programs like Stockfish are virtually unbeatable. In 2011, the Watson system was capable of answering questions posed in natural language. Watson received the first place prize of $1 million playing Jeopardy against some top contestants like Ken Jennings. ChatGPT was introduced in 2022. As we have seen, it is able to generate intelligible responses on many subjects. Some scientists predict that by the year 2045, computer intelligence will surpass human intelligence. Perhaps by that time, these computers will understand that the elliptical geomorphology of the Carolina Bays implies that they originated as inclined conical cavities. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and ChatGPT. No animals were harmed in the production of this video. All the kicks were theoretical. There is a link to the LiDAR visualization tool in the description of the video. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.